Hello everyone, this is EVG, and welcome to another edition of The Perfect Storm. Today I'm going to be talking about Square Enix's presentation, and how their E3 presentation will, to me, be absolutely perfect. Now again, this is basically my wish list based on what we know and what we could see that we don't know. So, as such, this video is completely and totally subjective and biased. So if you disagree with my opinions, hey, that's okay. But let me know what you think Square Enix, what you would want Square Enix to show in order to make it the perfect E3 for you. Now, let's go ahead and get into it. Let's start with what we know. So, we know a few things about Square Enix's E3, as they've been very much teasing a lot going into it, almost raising our expectations pretty much exponentially. And for good reason, because here's what we know is going to be at their E3. We know we're going to see Final Fantasy VII Remake, because they've already said that there will be more information in June. And what's in June at E3? I think it's pretty much a given. We also know that they will finally be showing off Crystal Dynamics, the Marvel's The Avengers. Oh boy, Marvel's The Avengers. I have a lot to say on that, but give me a minute. We also know that they're working on a brand new IP. I forget the name. I'm going to search it up real quick. But they are working on a brand new IP that they've been teasing over Twitter for a while. And it looks pretty interesting. It's just a bunch of people in cryostasis, which is weird. But hey, that's how Xenoblade Chronicles X started off, and I really enjoyed that game. So, you know, maybe it's not a bad thing. Beyond that, not much else is known. We know that we'll get some more Final Fantasy XIV content, because I feel like that's a given. But out of what we know, what would they need to do in order to really win E3 for me? Let's start with Final Fantasy VII Remake, because this one's pretty easy. Tifa. Just Tifa. Just show me Tifa and we're good. Nah, but in all seriousness, I want to know more about the gameplay, because we've only seen snippets at this point. We've gotten our big story trailer and whatnot, but I want to know more about how the game is supposed to play. How does a turn-based RPG change into an action RPG? Are limit breaks still a thing? If so, how do they work? You know, how is everyone going to attack you? How are you going to attack everyone? How do your party members fare in this? This is all the information I would like to know, pretty much. Along with, like, a release date or release window. If they gave us a release date for, like, October, that would be really good. Or December. And, you know, I want, we have confirmation that it's episodic. But I want to know what's included in the episode. Like, episode one in particular. And when can we expect the later episodes? I feel like Square is usually good about their episodic games when they're story-based, i.e., Life is Strange. But outside of that, not very good with their stuff. Alright, I just found it. It's Outriders. That's the other game they're working on that they've been teasing for a while. Outriders. Definitely interested in that. That's going to be pretty exciting. Alright. So, that's pretty much all I can think of as far as Final Fantasy VII Remake. Because outside of that, we know what we're getting. We're getting Final Fantasy VII. Just pretty. Just not blocky and pretty, right? So I just want to, that's pretty much all I want to know. Release date, Tifa, how combat works, Tifa, you know, how the episodes are going to be released, and Tifa. All right. Moving on, let's talk about Marvel's Avengers. Hoo boy! Now here's the thing. There was a recent interview with Bill Roseman at Game Informer during their Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 cover month, and I remember Bill was asked about whether the Marvel Gameverse will be connected in any way. So, like, Marvel Spider-Man connected with Marvel's Avengers. And, you know, he danced around it because that's what they do. But I don't know if I want that. I really don't. I'm not sure if I really want that. It depends entirely on how this game is going to play. So once we see this game, I want to know how it's going to play and how it's going to work. Now, recently, a description leaked out, and it talked about how, you know, you're building out this fleshed-out world or something. Like, you're a hero, and this world is constantly changing and everything. And many people feel like that alludes to it being games as a service. I don't think that directly alludes to it being games as a service. And I really, really hope that it is not a games as a service game. I hope that it is a full single player, perhaps multiplayer, like co-op multiplayer, adventure game, action adventure game, where you just play as all the different Avengers and you work to accomplish one goal. What that goal is, I don't know. Like, there's a lot of different stories they can adapt with the Avengers, and a lot of different Avengers that they can even pull from. So, as for my wish list, I would love for them to pull from a whole range of Avengers. So, not just the basic Iron Man, Hulk, Thor, Captain America. I mean, bring in Spider-Man, bring in Black Panther, bring in Ant-Man and Wasp, even though they're kind of the basic ones, but hey, just bring in as many characters as you can that would fit in the Avengers line. Bring in Luke Cage and is Blade an Avenger? I think Blade was an Avenger. I know Luke Cage was one of the Avengers, and then there was Wolverine as well. Bring in Wolverine, that would be cool as well. So yeah, just bring in a whole range of Avengers and just make it super fun. I'd also like, I know I mentioned, like, accomplish one goal. I'd like for there to be multiple stories in this. The Avengers are a superhero team that have to fight a common enemy, yes. But I'd love for them to kind of branch out and just do a whole lot. Marvel's Spider-Man by Insomniac was a fantastic game that I really wish they did more with. Because at the end of the day, it only centered around one major story. Which is why I appreciate the DLC so much, because it branches out to other stories. So I'd love to see them kind of do some side stuff as well. Be like, hey, we've got to deal with this massive threat of Ultron taking over the world. But over here in this ancient temple, there's Fing Fang Foom who's going around and trying to destroy everything. So let's deal with Fing Fang Foom real quick as the immediate issue, and then we'll work our way to Ultron. See, that kind of stuff. That would be really cool. Spider-Man kind of had that with Shocker, but at the end of the day, it all related to the main plot, and I get that, but have more side stuff in there. I love the Kingpin stuff. I love the Shocker stuff in Spider-Man. So do more of that in Marvel's Avengers. I've mentioned this in the last Perfect Storm, but a lot of my stuff is going to be, I want this on the Switch centric. Yep, you guessed it. I want this on the Switch. But on all platforms, please, and thank you. If this one doesn't come to the Switch, I don't mind. It's not that big a deal. I'll pick it up on PS4 and play it. Because I just love Marvel that much. Shoot, if Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 was an Xbox exclusive, I'd buy an Xbox One for it. I straight up would. I wouldn't even care. Because that is currently my most anticipated game of the year. So, yeah. All in all, just really, really, really excited for Marvel's Avengers. And I hope you guys really bring it home for me. Now I know that I said optional, like co-op multiplayer and whatnot. Here's another thing. I don't want this game to be too similar to Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3. Because if it is, I'll just play Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3. Because look, if Marvel's Avengers, let's say for example, Marvel's Avengers is the Infinity War storyline. So you have to fight Thanos at the end. That's the main story beat. And it plays similar to Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, where you have like, you have actions, regular actions, and you could do local four player, you know, kind of top down, kind of to the back and whatnot. And then you explore and whatnot. If it did all of that, I'd rather just play Marvel Ultimate Alliance. Because here's the thing. Marvel Ultimate Alliance versus Avengers. Marvel's Avengers is going to have the Avengers, as we know. And, of course, like I said in my wish list, I would love for them to include Wolverine, Spider-Man, Luke Cage, other Avengers, right? Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 is doing that and more. Inhumans, Spider-Verse, X-Men, Guardians of the Galaxy, Defenders, possibly even the Fantastic Four. So, obviously, like, even if Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 doesn't look as pretty as Marvel's Avengers, I'm going with Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 because it's got way more characters, way more storylines, way more just everything. So don't make it too similar to that, or I will just play Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3. That's just how it is. Alright, and that's about the end of that. Now, let's talk about Outriders, because we know nothing about it. Square Enix has just been teasing it. That's it. Just teasing it gradually with these little Twitter stuff. With this little Twitter stuff. I'm interested, somewhat, but I have no idea what this game could be. Now that I think about it, why am I talking about it if I had no idea what this game would be? I guess it's just because it reminds me so much of how you start off Xenoblade X that I'm thinking, oh, this could be a lot like Xenoblade X. And Square Enix could do that. They're really good with RPGs, so they could definitely do that. But, eh. I guess we'll know when we see it, right? If it's something really great, then that's awesome. So that's my wish list for Outriders. I just hope it's something really great. And then we've got Final Fantasy 14, and I really don't care about Final Fantasy 14. So that's kind of gonna go over there. Alright, so that's it based on what we know. So what don't we know, or what exists? Let's consider like what exists and we don't know is gonna be at E3, but could very well be. Babylon Fall. That is the game that is made by Platinum and published by Square Enix. I just want to see it. I want to see what it is. I want to see how it plays and how it works. Platinum makes great games. I have not yet played a Platinum game that I haven't enjoyed. I say this all the time. I have not yet played a Platinum game that I haven't enjoyed. And I've played Star Fox Zero. So, I love Platinum. And I would love to see what Babylon Fall is like. So, and mixed with Square Enix properties, I mean, Nier Automata is fantastic from what I've seen anyway. I haven't played it yet. I do plan on playing it at some point. I'm holding out past this E3 because of a reason I'm going to get into in a moment. But Babylon Fall, I just want that Platinum action with that Square Enix flair to it. Now let's talk about Nier Automata. Nier Automata is done. I don't think it's going to get updated anymore, and we're pretty much just waiting on a Nier Automata 2. However, last year they released Nier Automata on the Xbox One, and now Nier Automata has sold over 4 million copies worldwide. Now I think is the perfect time to finally put Nier Automata on the Switch. Expand your horizons. Expand the play area. And I guarantee you, a lot of people will enjoy playing this game on the Switch. Why? Because Nier Automata, at the end of the day, is an action RPG. And action RPGs, despite having a lot of action in them, take a long time to finish. Guess what you could do with the Switch? Pick it up, take it with you on the go, be able to play those long games. That's what I want. That's why I want Nier Automata on the Switch, so I can just pick it up, play it wherever I go, and complete the game, I guess, 9-10 times, because apparently it has a bunch of alternate endings. Ooh boy. But yeah, I would love that. I would absolutely love that. Life is Strange. Put it on Switch. There we go. That, again, this is the pattern. Look, Life is Strange, put it on Switch. I know they're gonna probably do a new chapter of it or something. Or another spinoff, like they did last time with Captain Spirit. But, yeah, just put it on Switch. That's all I want. Just put it on Switch. What else? Let's talk about Kingdom Hearts. Because that's another thing we do know. Remind, I think, is what it's called, and it's supposed to be coming soon to Kingdom Hearts 3. I don't know too much about Kingdom Hearts 3, aside from some, like, funny haha videos from Alpharad, but, yeah, I'd love to see them kind of expand Kingdom Hearts 3 a little bit, if they can. Beyond that, again, here we go. Kingdom Hearts 1.5, 2.5, 2.8, that whole collection, put it on Switch. Boom. And now I can play Kingdom Hearts, because... Or, not can play, but now I'll probably play Kingdom Hearts. Because I've never played a Kingdom Hearts game before. And I'd be interested to try it out. Just don't mess up the control scheme like you did. What was it? The World Ends With You. Because that's what kept me from getting that game. And the price. But, that and the price. But, yeah. Excuse me. What I also like to see is something from some of the smaller stuff. You know, the people who make Octopath. I'd love to see... We know it's been teased. I'd love to see Bravely Third. If you can reveal that, that would be amazing. And also, to coincide with that, get Default and Second on the Switch. Or just on platforms in general. Switch and PS4 if possible. Get Bravely Default and Bravely Second on Switch and PS4 if possible. That would be amazing. And then, yeah, bring Bravely Third to the Switch. I would love that. I would absolutely love that. And if they can work on an Octopath sequel, I know they are working on one, but, you know, showing it off would be interesting. I don't know if they'll do that, though, because they're still working on the prequel. Or is that out already? I don't remember. But either way, that kind of stuff would be really cool. Alright, and yeah, I think that's all I can really say about Square Enix. I know I mentioned in my predictions video that we'll get more Final Fantasy ports to the Switch. So, I guess to cover that in my wish list, let's say Final Fantasy 13, the original Final Fantasy, so like 1 through 6, and... like a 1 through 6 collection, and Final Fantasy Tactics, and a new theater rhythm Final Fantasy game on the Switch. Boom, there you go. Alright. And I think that's actually it. Alright? So let me know what you think about my little wish list for Square Enix's conference. Is there anything in here that you would also like to see? Am I a filthy Nintendo Switch fanboy? Yes, I am. Yes, I very much am. But let me know what else you would like to see in case I missed anything. Please let me know. Alright, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more. I'm going to be doing E3 coverage throughout the entirety of E3, and these videos will come out beforehand. So, yeah. that's gonna be it. Next time, I'll talk about Nintendo. Alright? Finally. That's it for me. I'll catch you guys in the next one. See you later.